Anytime you can win a game, you'll take it. But Richmond Hill won ugly last week against Bryan County. The Wildcats now host a team that won't have any problem playing in Richmond Hill. That team is the Johnson Atom Smashers. Last season, Johnson ended its 25-game losing streak in Richmond Hill, and since that time holds a 6-4 record, including a 39-14 victory over Long County last week. In that game, Johnson, which struggled to run the ball last season, totaled 280 yards on the ground. That, with a more than capable quarterback in Christian Cooper, makes Johnson a dangerous and balanced offense. Richmond Hill's offense, while totaling nearly 300 rushing yards, struggled at times just getting a snap off and finished the game with 11 fumbles, though only three of which were recovered by Bryan County. Wildcats have to get the offense figured out as the Smasher defense surrendered only 14 points to a very good Long County offense and forced 6 blue tie turnovers last week. Last Friday's performance just confirmed to me what I suspected about Richmond Hill when I saw them scrimmage Groves in the preseason. I saw a sloppy offense that struggled to get the snap off, and lo and behold, that's exactly what happened last week. Until the Wildcats can consistently get the snap off, I can't see them beating a capable team like Johnson. And I see the Smashers winning this one 24-6.